Silverleaf nightshade's a perennial weed, and it's all through the sheep wheat belt in Australia. It's also in a lot of other countries around the world, anywhere there's a temperate or subtropical climate. And the problem with it in Australia is it reduces the yields in crops and pastures. It reduces yield by using water and nutrients during the late spring summer period. And depending on the season, we've seen anywhere from no and damage at all, right through to 77% yield loss. Typically, people would be looking at 20 to 30%. The other problem with silverleaf nightshade is it's very hard to control once it's established. It's got a really deep root system, so you can kill the top of it, but it's really hard to kill the root system as well. Where we're standing is a long-term saggart project, and this particular trial is to have a look at the effect of herbicides over the long term. With a perennial weed, you can get some idea by spraying it once and then looking, but to get a good idea, you really need to track it long term, because it's a perennial root system we're working with. So in this case, the plots have been sprayed either three times a row, so over 3 years, or two treatments, and we're looking at treating the plots behind me for 6 years in a row. And by that time, after 6 years, you start to get a pretty good idea of what's happened to the numbers. There's a mixture of different treatments. What I've called the broadacre trial that I'm standing in behind us here is designed to be economically affordable. There's no point doing research on things that are way too expensive. So I've looked at some novel ideas, newer chemistry in the herbicides coming along. But we're also testing some of the normal, what's called summer brews for melons and heliotrope. A lot of herbicides like 2,4-D will actually control the shoots and do a little bit of damage to the root system, but it grows back the next year. If it's a spot spraying situation, there are herbicides like Tordon or glyphosate that are effective for odd plants, but obviously not suitable for a whole paddock. There is one thing with the control though, even though you might be spraying it every year, year after year, you might not be making a dent on the actual numbers, but you might be increasing the yield of the crop or pasture in the following year. So in that sense, it's worthwhile controlling them like any other summer weed. And we've also experimented with a few odd things to try and manipulate the plant in the very early stages of research, but some ideas work and some don't. So we'll see what happens after 6 years.